Yes, be ready. 5 seconds. Start. The Supreme Court held that if the court has to completely disregard the lack of corroboration of the testimony of police witnesses by independent witnesses and to turn a Nelson's eye to the independent witnesses turning hostile, then the story of the prosecution should be very convincing and the testimony of the official witnesses notably trustworthy. If independent witnesses come up with a story which creates a gaping hole in the prosecution theory, about the very search and seizure, then the case of the prosecution should collapse like a pack of cards. Corroboration by independent witnesses is not always necessary. But once the prosecution comes up with a story that the search and seizure was conducted in the presence of independent witnesses and they also choose to examine them before court, then the court has to see whether the version of the independent witnesses who turned hostile is unbelievable and whether there is a possibility that they have become turn court stop. Section 54 of the NDPS Act raises a presumption and the burden shifts on the accused to explain as to how he come into possession of the contraband stop. But to raise the presumption under Section 54 of the NDPS Act, it must first be established that a recovery was made from the accused stop. The Supreme Court held that the test which the Supreme Court and the High Courts are required to apply while granting bail is whether there are reasonable grounds to believe that the accused has not committed an offence and whether he is likely to commit any offence while on bail stop. The bench observed that stringent parameters of the grant of bail under the NDPS Act have been prescribed in order to curb the menace of drug trafficking in the country. The bench further observed that under Section 37 (1)(b)(3) of the NDPS Act, the limitations on the grant of bail for offences punishable under Sections 19, 24, or 27A and also for offences involving a commercial quantity are the prosecutor must be given an opportunity to oppose the application for bail and there must exist reasonable grounds to believe that the person is not guilty of such an offence and he is not likely to commit any offence while on bail stop. The Supreme Court held that while avoiding the sentence oblique punishment in case of the NDPS Act, the interest of the society as a whole is required to be taken into consideration and while striking a balance between the mitigating and aggravating circumstances, public interest, impact on the society as a whole will always tilt in favor of the suitable higher punishment stop. The bench observed that in a murder case, the accused commits murder of one or two persons, while those persons who are dealing in narcotic drugs are instruments in causing death or in inflicting death blow to a number of innocent young victims who are vulnerable, it causes deleterious effects and deadly impact on the society, they are a hazard to the society. द बेंच फर्दर ऑब्जर्व दैट ऑर्गेनाइज्ड एक्टिविटीज ऑफ द अंडरवर्ल्ड एंड द क्लैंडस्टाइन स्मगलिंग ऑफ नारकोटिक ड्रग्स एंड साइकोट्रॉफिक सब्सटेंसेस इनटू दिस कंट्री एंड इलीगल ट्रैफिकिंग इन सच ड्रग्स एंड सब्सटेंसेस शैल ले टू ड्रग एडिक्शन अमंग ए साइजेबल सेक्शन ऑफ द पब्लिक पार्टिकुलरली द एडोलसेंट्स एंड स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ बोथ सेक्सेस एंड द मिनेंस हैज एज्यूम्ड सीरियस एंड अलार्मिंग इन द रिसेंट ईयर्स स्टॉप स्टेंजा।